Hi guys, so I haven't done a video again in a while. I think I'm going to change up to like weekly vlogs just because we can get more content in it that's a bit more interesting rather than me just talking like every day. Yeah, because I've just been forgetting to do it, to be honest with you, so each week will probably be a bit better. I've got some big news since my last vlog. I am now without the leg brace, which means I just have the foot brace, which is really good. However, as you can see, size of calf, very different on each leg. So, I've lost a lot of muscle from my leg, so I'm having to work on that. I had physio this morning at 8:30. That was really good. I managed to get on an exercise bike. My physio Anita has let them know that I will be coming into the gym pretty much every day to use the bike, use the weights, the leg press that they've got there, and use the step machine as well. So I've got some more like exercise that I can do now that's gonna be really good, you know, and help keep the weight off as well. I've been struggling a bit. Yesterday was a really bad day for diet. I just kind of ate crap all day, and now I'm kind of trying to get back into it. It's one of those things where once you get into a routine, it seems to be a lot easier to kind of stick to it. But yeah, so I can walk without a leg brace now, which is a big deal. Second skin graft taken, healing okay. I've got dressings changed tomorrow at 2, and then I've got NHS physio on Thursday at 2. This weekend, Marek and Rossi are coming down. Rossi's bringing his new girlfriend, who I haven't met, so yeah, that should be good as well. Just kind of trundling along now. I've got a new obsession with The Office, the US version of The Office, which is now kind of a massive distraction for me, so I'm trying to find lots of stuff to do, playing a lot of guitar, haven't learnt much French, need to get back on that, haven't learnt any piano because the piano hasn't been moved. I had a really nice weekend, went out with Jess on Friday night, and then Saturday I went to the pub with Tom, my friend from school, and then Tom, another Tom from down the road, and his girlfriend, and then Jess joined us as well. And then yesterday was just, we went to this food market that was amazing. It's like a Sicilian food market, and it was really cool, but unhealthy food. So ate crap there, and then went to this a place called Orange Buffalo, which is in Shoreditch, and had buffalo wings there, and I ate their spiciest wing, and that did, like, I was in pain for a good 2 hours. It was 6 million Scoville units, I think they said it was. So yeah, good weekend.
Take a seat right over there, sat on the stairs, stay or leave. The cabinets are bare and I'm unaware of just how we got into this mess. Got so aggressive, I know we meant all good intentions. So pull me closer, why don't you pull me close? Why don't you come on over, I can't just let you go. Oh baby, why don't you just meet me in the middle? I'm losing my mind just a little. So why don't you just meet me in the middle? In the middle. Baby, why don't you just meet me in the middle? I'm losing my mind just a kitchen floors are wet and taps are still running, dishes are broken. How did we get into this mess? Got so aggressive. I know we meant all good intentions. So pull me closer. Why don't you pull me close? Why don't you come on over? I can't just let you go. Oh, baby. Why don't you just meet me in the middle? I'm losing my mind just a little. So why don't you just meet me in the middle? In the middle. Looking at you, I can't lie. Just pouring out admission, regardless of my objection. Oh, and it's not about my pride. I need you on my skin, just come over, pull me in, just. Oh, baby, why don't you just meet me in the middle?
Hi guys, so it's Sunday morning. I'm just in the middle of doing some muscle stim stuff for rehab. I had a dressings change on Friday, and basically what they said is that we need to find out what's going to happen, like what the where they're going to go with the nerve surgery. So something that's a little bit annoying and kind of frustrates me a bit is apparently they might go in the side, which means I could have had this nerve surgery done a while ago. Which means I've been waiting for however long for no reason. But that is what it is, you know, it's done now, I can't change that. But if they're not going to go in through the side, so where I had my first op, then they're going to go down the back, and if that's the case, then we have to wait until the skin on my skin grafts has healed completely and kind of gone back to full thickness, because otherwise the skin won't hold the stitches and it will be too fragile to kind of do anything with. So yeah, not the best news, but at least I'm kind of a bit more in the know now and I kind of know what's going on. I can only apologise for the sound of my voice. I've had a horrendous cold for the past like 5 days, which really stopped me from doing any exercise. I had physio yesterday morning, and that was really good. It was a hard session. Anita, who's my new physio, kind of really made me work hard, and I was sweating, and by the end of it my legs had gone all wobbly, so it felt good to get a sweat up again and kind of be pushing myself, pushing the limits of what I can do. That's really important for me. Like I've already said to you, I'm very competitive, so being competitive with myself is probably the healthiest thing. Apart from that, obviously on this video there'll be some stuff of me doing the outboard motor. Unfortunately, stuff didn't go to plan because one of the screws was just stuck and I had to spray WD-40 on it and leave it for 2 days before I could actually get it out. Yeah, that was tricky. So Marek, my friend, is upstairs. I saw James, I don't know why I call him James, Rossi, one of my other mates from school, one of my best mates. He came down, we went to the pub with him, and met his girlfriend, Liv. She's lovely. It's been a really good couple of days. It just got to the point where I started to really need visitors. So, you know, I think mentally I've been struggling a bit, so kind of seeing two of my best mates kind of helps that. My birthday's coming up in 3 weeks, so I'm trying to organise lots of people to come down for that, coming down to London. So I've started inviting people. We're going to try and have a really nice barbecue. And hopefully that'll be that'll be good. We're going to have family and friends there, so I needed this weekend quite badly. My anxiety was getting really bad, just from being on my own and leaving me alone with my own thoughts is quite a dangerous game, and it's something I'm learning to manage kind of every day. I have to write a lot of what I'm thinking down, and what I've learned, I think, is that there's no boundaries to what lengths your mind will go to kind of screw you up effectively. Well, at least mine might. So I'm yet again learning more and more stuff about my own mental health. Never assume you know everything about yourself, because you don't. So I'm learning more every day, and it's really, you know, it's really tough at times, and then other times it's really helpful. So I was really glad that Marek and Rossi made it down, and Liv, obviously. So shout out to Rossi and Liv for coming down to see me. Marek's upstairs in bed. We're going to have a barbecue, just me and him. Lucy's gone back to Durham today, so I won't see her until June, which is a bit sad, but I'm sure we'll FaceTime or something soon. I think that's been something that I've realised recently that is really nice, is my relationship with my sister has become a lot stronger. We're a lot closer than we ever have been before, I think. Not as far as like talking about, but like we can just have a laugh together, and I think we're more like friends than siblings. I mean, I'm still the annoying older brother who winds her up, but when we were kids we used to fight all the time, and I think that's changed quite a lot. So she's been amazing at looking after me, so a massive thank you to her. I think she was a bit worried about me when she found out about what was happening, because I got injured as she was going back to Durham after Christmas. It's been really good to have her home and have someone to kind of chat to, and you know, I never say it face to face, which is probably a fault of mine, but very proud of how well she's done so far, and she seems to be doing really well at uni. Still needs to learn how to drink properly though, because she had a bit of a mess the other night, but I'm sure we can teach her that. Anyway, I don't think there's much else to say, to be honest with you. I'm going to try and video a bit more, I'm going to try and vlog a bit more. Obviously this is going to be the first vlog in a while, so I'll try and be better at putting up more. So, yeah. Peace.